welcome to this video. Now in this video we are going to solve for the cube root of iota, where iota is said to be the square root of negative 1, right? So what's the cube root of this man here, iota? So raise it to 1/3 power. What's the 1/3 power of iota? Right. Now let's take note that we start from here. And the cube root of iota will produce a complex number in the form a plus ib. So if this is the case, then we say cube root of iota is equals to a plus ib, of which this is a complex number having a real part a and the imaginary part ib. Right? So if we take the cube of both sides, say we cube both sides, let's go side to power 3, we're going to have the cube root of I, then we raise this to power 3, that would become a plus ib to power 3. Alright, so doing this way, I would say the cube of I will produce I, right? We're going to have I equals to, now let's take the cube of this side, the minimal expansion of the two terms. Already. So we're going to have a cube, okay, plus 3aib, right, minus 3ab squared, right? I hope you know why it's minus. You know, since this is I, and I is said to be the square root of negative 1. So if you square that, you're going to have negative 1. So negative 1 times 3 is negative 3ab squared. Okay, so we say plus, the next thing will be minus b cube. The same thing is applicable. If you square this, take this to power 3, that is the I now. That will become square root of negative I squared times square root of negative I. So square root of negative I squared is negative 1. Square of negative I is just I. So negative 1 times I is negative I. Alright? So this is negative I. Right. So from here, our iota is equal to this. And take note that this unit complex number, iota, like with the coefficient 1, okay? It has a real part, which is 0. So we're going to write 0 plus iota to be equal to this. Now, taking note of that, let's move from there. Let's equate the real part together and the imaginary part together. So the real part here is 0, will be equal to, these are the real parts. These are the real numbers, while these other ones are the imaginary numbers. So we say a cubed minus 3ab squared. Okay, so the imaginary part will be 1, which is the coefficient of the I, is equals to the other part, say 3, let me write this. So this will be the imaginary part. 1 is equals to 3ab. Oh, this is a squared, sorry. 3a squared b, right, minus b cubed. I actually forgot to put square here. You know, binomial expansion, the powers of a will be reducing while the powers of b will be increasing. Okay, so having this, I call this set of equations, simultaneous set of equations. Solving this as equation 1 and 2, right, we solve for that for the values of a and b. So from equation one, we will have that a cubed is equals to 3ab squared. And if that's the case, that would mean that a squared, you know, if a cancels on both sides, will be equals to 3b squared. Let's call that equation 3. Right. Now let's go to equation 2. Now let's substitute the value of a squared, since we have a squared here. Substitute the value of a squared in equation 3 into equation 2. So that would give us 1 equal to 3. So in place of a squared, we're going to put 3b squared. 3b squared times b minus b cubed. Right. So let's solve this further for the value of b, since it's only b that we have as the unknown. So that will become 1 equals to 9b cubed minus b cubed. Right. So what do you think b will be from here? What? That will become 1 equals to what? 8b cubed. So solving for b, we'll have b equals to, our b is equal to 1. The cube root of both sides. The cube root of 1 is 1. The cube root of 8 is 2. So b is equals to 1 over 2. Right. Now we've gotten the value of b. Let's substitute the value of b into equation 3 to solve for a. So substitute into 3. So that would be, that become a squared equals to 3 times. Now, you know that b is 1 over 2, so b squared will be 1 over 2 squared. Right? Yeah. Okay, so at this point, we're going to say that a squared equals to, that will become 3 over 4. So if a squared is 3 over 4, then a will be what? The value of a will be, you take the square of both sides, positive, negative, root 3 over 2. So this is the value of a. Alright, so we solve for our value of a and we solve for our value of b. I recall that I said that the cube root of I, okay, should be equal to what? A complex number, a plus ib, where a and b are real numbers and ib is the imaginary part. So if that's the case, then we'll say that the cube root of iota, right, is equal to, now a here has two values, so let's consider it positive first. Positive root 3 over 2 plus, what's the value of b? 1 over 2. So there's I times 1 over 2. I 1 over 2. Or I will be equal to what? The square root of, the negative square root of 3 over 2 plus I 1 over 2. Okay. So with these two values, I can say these are the cube root of iota. Maybe this video is helpful. And please subscribe to SunTrust. Just click that icon with a face. Alright, thanks for watching.